Elementary concepts of objects and classes. Part 1 video. This is for class 9. Definition of object. An object is any physical or conceptual thing that we can find around us in our real world. So the things like chair, table, glass, books, TVs, etc., etc. These are all objects which we are seeing in the real world. These objects share a common three characteristics. They are identity, state, and behavior. For example, identity is a name given to an object. Like, if you have a pet cat, then you must have given a name. Suppose Tom the cat. So the cat's name is Tom. So it is its identity. Or a stereo model number. Stereo, suppose you have a stereo headphone. So the headphone you have bought from Amazon or Flipkart, these have a specific model number which states that it has a certain features. A dog has states like name, color, and breed. Suppose an Alsatian dog. So Alsatian dog is the breed. The Alsatian is the breed. Suppose a dog name is Tom. So the name of the dog is Tom, and if the dog is in black color, so it is one of the state. So we can say that Tom the dog has a black color, which is a Alsatian breed. So the dog is an object. Now the behavior. So an object has two states, state and behavior. So how does a dog behave in our real world? They bark, they fetch, they waggle their tail. So we can say that it's object behavior. The stereo speaker has a states like color, switch, buttons, and motors. And behavior like playing tape, rewinding, fast forwarding. Then we can add certain more behaviors like pause, resume, that kind of stuff. So a stereo speaker, you might say, has a certain color. You might say your stereo headphone is in white color or a black color headphone. The buttons on the stereo set is the switch buttons, and the motor, I mean to say, it represent those magnetic things inside your buds from where you hear your sound. So these are the state. And behavior saying that the thing with which we can do the certain things like rewinding, playing, stopping, resuming, these kinds of steps. These are all state and behavior. Then objects. So how do you model a entity? So entity means that any important features are called entities. So entities can be methods, variables for an object. So what are the conditions we should remember for developing or modeling an entity? A model is simplification of a reality. We model because we cannot comprehend the complexity of a system in its entirety. We model to visualize, specify, construct, and document the structure and behavior of a system architecture. A model is a complete description of a system from a particular perspective. Let us take an example for a car. If you make a model of a car, what we can say that the model, what are the basic features which we see in a car? Like the engine is also a part of the car, is one of the most important part. Then the tires, then the wheels, then the axle shaft. These are all the structure or state of a model. So here we can say that the model can be a replica of a car. So suppose a toy car may be a replica of a certain car like Ferrari. So what are the basic things we can simplify in a small model? That there's a certain functions like starting the engine, turning on the lights, opening the gates. These are all the simplification we can do from a object. So how do we develop a model? We develop a model by seeing the actual reality. So if a Ferrari car has a certain features, we will try to incorporate the same features in a small scale structure in our model, so that we can understand that how the Ferrari cars works, so that it can travel such a at high speed. A model is a complete description of a system from a particular perspective. You can say that suppose you can take a car and make a particular perspective from yourself that how a car is working, which may or may not be entirely correct, but we always try to make a certain perspective and make certain notations from it. Principles of modeling. The choice of what models to create has a profound influence on how the problem is approached and how a solution is shaped. Every model may be expressed different levels of precision. The best models are connected to reality. No single model is sufficient. Every non-trivial system is best approached through a small set of nearly independent models. So what does it say? That the first point, the choice of what model to create has a profound influence. So if you try a very complicated model, so it will be definitely be difficult to create a model of what should we be making. Suppose you are taking an example of a train. So we more or less we all know that what are the functions of a train and how does it look. So it will be quite easier to make a model of it. But for example, if you try to make a model of a bullet train, so the bullet train working is quite different from a normal train. So it will be quite difficult to implement in a model. So it depends, these kinds of modeling of a certain real world object in a model is depends on how to approach the problem and how to reach the solution. Every model may be expressed different level of precision. So for a certain instance, you can say that you have been told to make a model of a train. Now the thing is that depending upon the time relative of you have, suppose you have more time, so you will be able to implement more and more precisions in the model as compared to the reality. But if we have less time, so you will get less amount of time to precise the design which should match the reality. The third point is that the best models are connected to reality. So if your model is very precise, then the no one will be able to tell the difference between the model and the real thing. So it should be achieved, but it is quite expensive to do that. The last thing is that no single model is sufficient. So if you want to make a model of a train, so you need to practice hard so that you can certainly do the final build with precise approach. This is the end of part 1.